What's happening?
Calm down. It's only a blackout. We already had one this afternoon.
I know where the fuse box is. You wait here.
Okay.
It's a blackout. I said half an hour ago, you should light the fire and you would burn.
I just got done with all the files. There are no records on AMC Gremlin. I really looked through every single one of them. It's absolutely impossible I missed one. So either this car was never at the garage or something.
So, I have looked as thoroughly as I could, and I'm afraid I have to tell you that there is absolutely nothing here. You hear? There's nobody here. No Hannah Dunford, no kidnapper. It's just me and the crime scene tape I put here. Arrival at Miss Lewis' apartment at 7:38. The victim's apartment is on the ground floor. Nobody has entered since the body was found. I am therefore able to get an unaltered, precise impression. Arrival at Miss Lewis' apartment at 7:38. The victim's apartment is on the ground. Arrival at Miss Lewis' apartment. Before I'm able to enter, I am faced with an unusual sight. Something has been drawn onto the front door with a dark red substance. Said substance is most likely blood. The shape that was drawn closely resembles a crow. Somehow, it seems familiar. The apartment appears to be clean and tidy. All windows are closed. The trash has been taken out. There aren't any lights on. Miss Lewis is the only person registered under this address, and so far I found nothing that would indicate any other. Something tells me that things aren't as they seem. I have finished my first inspection. I could not find anything suspicious at first glance. However, the body was only taken to the forest after she had already died. I assume this to be a message from the killer. I must continue my search if I want to understand this message. There is a small safe in the bedroom closet. Easy to see once the doors are open. The safe is locked and appears to be undamaged. It seems like nobody attempted to force it open. There's an envelope on the nightstand. Let's see what's inside it. Even though CSI is going to kill me for this. No address whatsoever. The envelope had obviously been sealed, but has been carefully opened again. Where's the letter? I have finished my second inspection. No sign of the letter from her bedroom, nor anything else suspicious. What in the world happened to you, Miss Lewis?
Can you hear me? That looks like no more messages are coming through. You need to do something for me. Call the police department in Duskwood. Explicitly ask for Eric Biggs. Talk to him and nobody else. Tell him. Who's there? My name is Alan Bloomgate, Duskwood Police Department. I'm approaching you with my weapon drawn. Make yourself known immediately. My goodness. Miss Dunford, are you all right?
I'm Richy. Please.
10 years ago. Hannah and Amy showed up on my doorstep. Pineglade was almost over. It was dark already. They wanted me to drive them to Grim Rock because Amy had lost something there. I can't even remember what it was. I had been at the festival the whole day, so I was drunk. I had a couple of drinks. I said no. But they insisted. They were in a hurry. And they already had made this huge detour to get to me, so. And I had been driving around our yard a couple of times. So I gave them the keys to an old AMC Gremlin, one that should have been scrapped a couple of days later. So I thought, there's no harm in that, right? A couple of minutes later, they showed up again. And I almost didn't recognize the car. Dark, with all its dents. There was blood on the windshield. There was blood on the bumper. And none of them were capable to, like, as much as utter a single word. And I thought, hey, it must have hit an animal, some deer that jumped in front of the car. So I drove them to the spot. And there she was. The girl. Covered in blood. Lifeless. We buried her in the forest. Never spoke a word of that again. I'm sorry. You're terrified of frogs. Just Phil put one in your bed when you were a kid. On your first day with us, you thought my dad wasn't the boss but the garbage man, which he let you believe for like 3 days. You were there when we got my mom's diagnosis. You started crying even before I did.
I don't believe you. You couldn't do any of this. You would never hurt me. Please, tell me that it's not true.
I never wanted to hurt you, Jesse. None of you. And I swear, I never touched Dan's car.
Please.
I'm sorry.
No, Richy.
Forgive me all of my fears, see through my scars and wounds and my false beliefs. I will for once now clear the rust of my heart. I'll let you hold the light that sees through my cards. These luxury shades now may fall out of my eyes. True colors of love and hate cannot be disguised. To me you're not roses, and I don't need your songs. Just be my escape and help me break these walls.
Thank you.